All right, you ready?
Yeah. Listen,
I've traveled every road in this here land. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I've traveled, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere.
All right, let's go. Let's do this. We got Aaron Allen here from London, Ontario, joining us with Bandwagon TV, Quarantine Confessions. We wanted to give him a big round of applause, and we're very excited to have him here with us today. We appreciate your time, sir.
Thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
I heard about you. I've been following some country artists for a little while now. I sent you a message and just pretty excited that I was able to get you on here with Quarantine Confessions. And for people that aren't familiar with you, maybe people that are that want to learn a little more about you, explain, I guess, who you are, where you're from, a little bit about your musical influences.
Sure. So Aaron Allen, I'm from London, Ontario. I'm originally from Chatham, which is just kind of about an hour away from London. I've been doing music now for about 20 years. You know, I've been in the country for a long time, folk, stuff like that. Started out in punk music. The last few records have been really just country-centric. Yeah, I got a new EP out called Highway Mile. You can get it on all platforms. Request that radio here in Canada. I'm a tattoo artist as well. So I've been doing that for about 6 years. And that pays the bills, and music's on the rise, so hopefully that can pay all the bills soon, but we'll see. It's a tough go. It's been good lately, though.
It really has, man. I mean, I started listening to your EP you just mentioned, The Highway Mile, and your song, the single Highway Mile, and it caught me. And I was like, man, I gotta have this guy on. And I know you've been in music for a little while. Being that you were a tattoo artist, I felt like, man, not only you got like more layers to you, you know, and not a typical music, country star. So I just, I appreciate that. And if you don't mind sharing, just what have you been up to with quarantine and having everything like that going up, really the same thing and same time up in Canada? What have you been doing to, I guess, keep you and your family sane?
Well, I got two kids. I got a one-year-old and a six-year-old, so they take up a lot of time, you know. They keep me busy. I'm definitely not starving for things to do. So, music has been on the rise, oddly enough, in this quarantine state. It feels like I've had more to do than ever, so that's pretty good. I'm usually down here. This is my basement. This is my little studio room, so I'm usually down here recording songs all day, writing. I write a lot over Skype and Zoom and stuff right now, so yeah, I've been super busy, even though all this craziness is going on, and hopefully it's done soon, that's for sure, because I'd like to get back to maybe some live shows and stuff.
Yeah, like all of us. We're just waiting for that live gig, my friend.
Yeah.
So are you, I guess, from a musical influence family?
Yeah, like my dad played guitar, my uncle plays drums, my brother plays drums. My brother was my drummer for, I don't know, 15 years or something. So, and then I've been with my wife for 20 years. So when I met her, my brother and I were jamming, and she was a piano player. And we said, well, why don't you learn the bass? We need a bass player. So then she became our bass player for a lot of years, maybe a decade or something. And she was a great singer. So we've been singing together for 20 years now.
Cool. Well, and just to, you know, briefly get into it, because you mentioned tattoo artists, that you and your wife have a tattoo parlor. How did you get started, and really, where did that come to be, becoming a tattoo artist?
Well, I always kind of dabbled in drawing, but my wife has been a tattoo artist for probably over 12 years now, and used to be a hairstylist, and we own a tattoo shop and a hair salon. And about 6 years ago, I kind of didn't want to cut hair anymore. I didn't want to be a hairstylist. I kind of get bored with things and go on to the next thing. So logically, it was like, hey, why don't I try this tattoo thing here? And she taught me how to tattoo, and I've been doing it for 6 years now.
Oh man, that's really cool. You got multiple levels.
Thanks. Well, I try. I always just say I'm crazy. My buddy calls me Homer Simpson. You know how Homer Simpson's had like 1,000 jobs?
Yeah.
I'm the same way, man. You only live once, so I'm going to do as many jobs as I can. I'm going to do as many things as I can.
Well, what's the next thing? Are you a bus driver?
Yeah, maybe I'll be a bus driver. I don't know. I think I can finally call myself a musician, you know, after all these years. Now that, I don't know, it's weird. I've been doing it so long, and now that you can pay the bills with it, I guess I consider myself a musician now, so that's the next thing.
Well, I think you should, man, especially with this EP. I'm really excited for you to play a song. But before we get into that, Aaron, I'm going to pull this bad boy over the white lightning so we can get started with the lightning round, if you don't mind.
All right.
All right, so if you're not aware, I'm unofficially sponsored by Whataburger. I love their sweet tea, their hamburgers, and their milkshakes are delicious. So I just wanted to make a quick plug that while in quarantine, just like I guess my infatuation with Harvey's hamburgers up in Canada, I love Whataburger just as much, if not more. So, with that, Aaron Allen, Mr. Allen, are you ready for the lightning round?
Let's do it.
All right, let's go. All right, Steve Earle or Lyle Lovett?
Oh, that's a tough one, man. That's tough. I guess I would say Steve Earle.
Yeah, well, I was hoping you'd say that. I mean, he's a big guy here in Texas, and we all love him. So we appreciate that answer, sir.
Yeah.
Now, this one's for you. Would you rather perform with your favorite musician or have him or her come into your shop for a tattoo?
Oh, I think I'd rather them come in for a tattoo because we could have a cool conversation there. Unless they're in too much pain, then they don't take the time. So that could backfire.
That's a deep...
I'll still say that one.
I love it, man. That I didn't really think when I was writing that here a second ago, I didn't really think the level of that is that while getting a tattoo, I mean, they're not just a quick thing in or out. I mean, it could be a deep, like maybe hour to few hours, you know, you drawing this tattoo on them and the amount of,
yeah.
of what information you could get out of this person would be amazing.
Yeah, I could pick their brain, right?
Yeah, for sure. Aaron, if you were stranded on an island, what band would you want to keep you company?
I guess I would say Bruce Springsteen and the E Street Band. That would be cool.
The Boss.
The Boss. That'd be all right.
I think he'd have some pretty good stories.
Yeah, definitely. And you know, if we're stranded on an island, he does long shows. So if the months drag on, yeah. he can do that, I think.
If we were to look into a playlist on your phone, is there a song or band that would surprise us?
Oh, I don't know. I'm all over the place. So, like, there's some pop in there. One, I always like to shout this guy out, but Sean McConnell. There's a song called One Acre of Land, but he's a great songwriter all around. But Sean McConnell is one that's really underrated that people might not know. You got to check that guy out.
Yeah, I'm not...
Terrific. Songwriter.
Where's he from?
Oh, I think he's in the Nashville area right now. I'm not sure where he's from, but okay. I think he lives in the Nashville area now.
Cool. Yeah, definitely not familiar, but we would love to check him out. Thank you very much.
For sure.
All right, you're doing great. We only got a couple more. All right, Aaron, if you're like us common folk, have you worn the same pants, more than 3 days in a row?
Yeah, all the time. In quarantine?
I was going to be a little conservative. I've gone from 2 to 4, but I thought I'm going to keep it real simple and keep it at 3. We're all glad knowing that you're just like us. I think I've worn the same pants for weeks now. And it, you know, I don't mind.
No, for sure. If I was going out on a day-to-day basis, probably not. But I mean, I got kids. I'm busy. Who cares? No one's going to see me or smell me right now.
That's right. Aaron, you're doing great. Last one. What is the first thing Aaron Allen will do once quarantine is all over?
The first thing? I wouldn't do anything special, man. And this sounds weird, but, you know, I think all the time if I got a disease and I only had a week to live, what would I do? I'm doing it right now. I wouldn't climb a mountain. I wouldn't play a stadium. I wouldn't do anything but hang out with my family. That's what I would do if I had a week to live. So I might go camping. Camping would be nice.
Okay. But still with your family. This is a great answer.
With the family. Yeah.
Yep, with the family. There we go. Family man, Mr. Aaron Allen. Well, sir, you did great.
Yeah.
We really appreciate it. Now this is on you. So plugs. I know you just plugged a little bit about your music and where to find you, but if you could just say it again, where do we find Aaron Allen music? How do we listen to you? How do we follow you on social media?
For sure. Everything is under Aaron Allen Music. So if you go to Facebook, Instagram, it's all Aaron Allen Music. We got AaronAllenMusic.com and I'm always repping Apple Music. Apple Music has been behind me for a long time and head on over to Apple Music or your favorite streaming platform and check out the new EP Highway Mile.
That's awesome. All right. I know that we're somewhat up in the air. We're very excited about the new EP. Do you have any plans or, I guess, tentative dates of what's going on in the future that we could look forward to?
No, I really, there's there's nothing there. You can't book any shows. You can't do anything. I think once COVID's over, it's just going to be maybe house shows and trying to salvage some shows at some small bars. Other than that, no. I'm working a lot on songwriting right now, and that's my main focus. And I hope, to get in the studio once this is over, too, and put out some new stuff. I know the new EP's coming out. Can We Go Back is going to be the new single that goes to radio. That is online. It's available everywhere, but I think that's the one we're going to radio with next.
Perfect. Great. Shout outs.
I hope everybody's doing well. Thank you everybody for always continuing with support, the shares. So I'd just like to thank everybody for helping grow my career. It's all because of you guys.
Well, we appreciate it, and we thank you, Aaron, for joining us. Just quick question. I love that hat. Is that your personal logo?
Yeah, that's the Aaron AA logo there with the anchor, because I got an anchor on my face. Oh, I always forget what side it's on. But it's right there, so my wife drew this up for me.
Yeah, that's cool, man. I like that.
No, thank you. I had an order pending, but now that it's in quarantine, they're not open, so I would have had some more hats. I could send you one, but the factory's closed down right now.
That's okay. You know what? When this is all over, we'll make sure that we plug your merch, because I'm sure I'm not the only one that'll want that hat.
Thank you.
All right, Aaron, you did great. Thank you so much. I hate to say this, but you were a great host in London, Ontario, but we got to get going. The White Lightning has other people to see and places to go. But if you don't mind, before we kick you out, do you mind playing us a song?
For sure, yeah. I'd love to play you a song. We'll do a happy one. These days, I don't feel like doing, the sad, emotional ones when we only got one song to do. So we'll do the happy, upbeat, good tattoo, if that's okay.
Hey, that's what we're all about here at Bandwagon TV.
Yeah. I see that. You're high energy. I feel high energy. Let's play a rocker. This is Good Tattoo.
Awesome.
We'll do the song Good Tattoo. Love is like a good tattoo. Yeah, it just looks good on you. Looks better when you're on my arm. For years to come. It's more than just skin deep. Don't you know it's about me? My love is like a good tattoo. It's forever, there's no going back. Our love can stand the test of time, just like that mundane line. It's not something that'll ever wear off. Yeah, baby, I swear it's time. With my heart on my sleeve, yeah, for all to see. Our love is like a good tattoo. Oh yeah. Our love is like a good tattoo. Might fade a little along the way. Trust me, babe, it's here to stay. Our love is like a good tattoo. It just looks good on you. It's more than just skin deep. Don't you know it's part of me? Our love is like a good tattoo. Is like a good tattoo. Our love is like a good tattoo. Our love is like a good tattoo.
was great. That was awesome.
Thank you.
Hey, that was fun.
Yes, that's the main thing. We're having fun now.
And now we can only hope that maybe one day you get Bruce Springsteen to go get that tattoo at your parlor.
That would be great. That would be amazing.
Well, hey, Aaron Allen, we appreciate it very, very much for joining us with Bandwagon TV Quarantine Confessions. Stay safe, sir.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
And we really do hope that... Yeah, thank you. And we hope that we see you in the near future.
Well, I'd love to come down and hit up the burger joint with you.
Hey, you're always welcome in Austin, my friend. So bring the family. We'll enjoy some good times.
Definitely. Thank you so much.
All right, man. Aaron, thank you very much. And we appreciate your time. Stay safe, all right?
Cheers. You too, buddy.